Hello, in this video we will see functions of surfactants in respiratory system. There are three main functions of surfactants. They increase compliance of lungs, prevent fluid accumulation in alveoli, and they stabilize size of alveoli. Let's see each function one by one. First, increasing lung compliance. This is a simplified diagram of lung. This is lung parenchyma, this is alveoli, and this is a layer of fluid on the wall of alveoli. Now, the surface tension of this fluid tends to collapse the alveoli. To expand the alveoli, we need extra efforts by respiratory muscles to overcome this surface tension. The more the surface tension, the harder it is to expand the alveoli. Surfactants decrease surface tension and decrease the tendency of alveoli to collapse. So less force is required to expand the alveoli. Thus, in presence of surfactants, it becomes easy to expand the alveoli, or in fancy words, the compliance of lungs increases. It also decreases work of breathing. That completes the first function. Now second function, preventing fluid accumulation in alveoli. Again, the high surface tension without surfactants tends to collapse the liquid in the alveoli. As it collapses, it draws fluid from the interstitium into the alveoli. This increases thickness of fluid layer and makes it difficult for gases to diffuse. And once again, surfactants by decreasing surface tension prevent this from happening. Now third function, stabilizing size of alveoli. This one is going to be lengthy. In absence of surfactants, small alveoli collapses into large alveoli. We will study how surfactants stabilize the size under three questions. Why small alveoli collapse into large alveoli? Why this should not happen? And finally, how surfactants prevent this? First, why this happens? To understand this, we first need to understand surface tension in an air bubble inside water. This is an air bubble. And these are water molecules that are coming in contact with air in the bubble. What happens at this air-water interface happens at this interface also. The water molecules on the surface are pulled deeper by water molecules in the bulk. This creates surface tension and decreases surface area of bubble. As the bubble gets smaller, the gas inside the bubble gets compressed and the pressure increases. This pressure opposes further collapse of the bubble despite the surface tension. At equilibrium, tendency of increased pressure to expand the bubble balances tendency of surface tension to collapse it. At this point, relationship between pressure, surface tension, and size of the bubble is described by Laplace law. Pressure equals 2 times the tension divided by radius. Thus, the more the tension or smaller the radius, the higher the pressure inside the bubble. Now what's the impact of this phenomenon in alveoli in lungs? Let's say we have two alveoli with same size at the end of the inspiration. Both are lined with the fluid. The surface tension of this fluid is increasing pressure on the air in the alveoli. At this point, surface tension, radius and pressure all are equal for both the alveoli. Now let's say this alveoli has an obstruction in its airway. It increases resistance to airflow to this alveoli as compared to the other one. During expiration, both the alveoli will start collapsing. Due to high resistance, this alveoli collapses more slowly. As this alveoli has no resistance, it collapses rapidly. Because of this, the size of both the alveoli is no longer equal. Now let's see the Laplace equation for both the alveoli. In this alveoli, radius is comparatively small, so pressure generated is higher. Whereas in this alveoli, the radius is larger, so pressure will be comparatively less. We know that air moves from high pressure to low pressure area. So here, air will move from small alveoli to large alveoli, resulting in collapse of smaller alveoli. This answers our first question. Why small alveoli collapses into large alveoli in absence of surfactant? Now second question, why this should not happen? The answer is to maintain alveolar surface area for gas exchange. Total surface area of uniformly sized alveoli is more as compared to surface area of this non-uniformly sized alveoli. This decrease in surface area impairs gas exchange. So it's important to prevent such collapse and stabilize the size of alveoli. That checks the second question as well. Now let's see how surfactants prevent the collapse of smaller alveoli into larger one. Again, we have those same alveoli with same size at the end of inspiration. But this time, they both have surfactants in the alveolar fluid. At this point, density of surfactants on the surface is equal in both the alveoli. So surface tension is also equal. As alveoli collapse during expiration, density of surfactants increases. This results in decrease in surface tension in both the alveoli. Now look at this alveoli. Radius of this alveoli is comparatively small. However, this smaller size also results in higher density of surfactants on the surface. So there is greater fall in surface tension in this alveoli. Final result is not much change in the pressure. Now this alveoli. It's bigger in size. So the density of surfactants is less. So surface tension is comparatively higher. Again, the final result is minimal change in the pressure. Thus, the adjustment in surface tension keeps the pressure in both the alveoli equal. So there is no air movement and collapsing of one alveoli into the other is prevented. This adjustment in surface tension is possible only because of surfactants. This is how surfactants stabilize the size of alveoli. That completes all three functions and the video. If you found this video helpful, please share it with your friends too. And don't forget to subscribe, because at Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.